the Hub Critic.
Just a quick note before we start this video, I must say that all video uses are owned by Fremantle International, which means I give full credit for Fremantle International for the producing of all the scenes and all the video. But I must say that I am using it, and I am giving credit to them, but I say I am using it in fair use. I am meeting the legal requirements because I'm making this as a review purposes. I'm not distributing this episode of Merlin, I'm using it for a review. So all scenes you see in this, in all the nature, are for a review. Thank you. Thanks for the discretion. Enjoy.
Merlin, Season 1, Episode 1, The Dragon's Call, Review. The episode starts with our epic voiceover as the young warlock Merlin finally arrives at Camelot. We are given our first few glimpses at the great castle. A beheading takes place, and due to a man using magic, King Uther mentions that he was the one who rid the kingdom of magic 20 years ago, and that it marks today, ironically, the 20-year anniversary of the dragon's capture, just as Merlin arrives. An old hag says of the one evil being the king of his hatred and ignorance, telling that his son was the one who was executed because of her magic, and that she would wreak revenge on the castle and the king, before disappearing with a pretty decent CGI. It is to note that a princess figure looks on from the window. We will see a lot of her later on. Moving on, the seemingly unfazed Merlin finds his way to Gaia. Merlin immediately slows time before forcing the bed to place to land as Gaius falls off a giant shelf thing. Gaius is shocked and incredibly realizes who Merlin is. It seems already that the sorcerers are expecting a lot of potential and legendary ability from Merlin himself, and Gaius becomes humbled, and it seems to have such a change of heart. We learn that from a flashback of his mother that he wanted Merlin to come here to be protected by Gaius, keeping him away from the small town where his magic was being shown off, and trying to, you know, hone in his potential skills. Morgana argues to Uther in a scene that follows that he didn't want him. That she doesn't want to execute the executions, she doesn't like the executions, and that magic is not the evil here. Uther reminds her that 20 years ago, she wasn't here when magic was probably a bigger problem back then, and where he had to face it himself. Moving on, we meet a mysterious woman figure camping before reaching Camelot. The old woman from earlier uses spells and a voodoo doll to kill the poor woman before harnessing her powers and becoming that woman. Our next scene is a weird way to wake up from Merlin, and so he gets up and has breakfast before performing a weird freeze that he claims he has no control over. Gaius grounds him by acting to giving the potions to different members of the royal family for his job. And at this point, it is worth placing our bets that he will probably inadvertently use his magic some form in the day that follows, after being told the contrary. We meet Uther's son, King Arthur, who is punishing the servant boy there by throwing knives at a shield after he made a mistake. Merlin says hello to him here.
Come on. I'm in jail for that.
Well, who do you think you are, the king?
No, I'm his son, Arthur.
Merlin gets a little in trouble after trying to stand up to the other guy and gets thrown in jail after threatening to fight Arthur. The imposter woman arrives, infiltrating the castle before arriving to greet the family as Lady Helen. Gaius is pissed, and Merlin's inapt behaviour somehow manages to get him out of jail, you know, with a bit of moving and shaking here, but there is one circumstance: Merlin must serve in the stocks. Later on, our friend Merlin meets Gwen at the stocks, the maid of Morgana.
Because you don't look like one of these big, muscly kind of fellows.
Thanks.
No, I'm sure you're stronger than you look. It's just, Arthur's one of these real rough, tough, save the world kind of men, and, well...
What?
You don't look like that.
I'm in disguise.
Well, it's great you stood up to him.
You think so?
Arthur's a bully, and Everyone thought you were a real hero.
Yeah, that was pretty awkward, like, to say the least. Geist discusses with Merlin that he has instinct for magic, unlike most, also saying that he is a symbol and object of magic trapped down in dungeons with the dragon, who is a symbol of magic. Merlin, after discussing some experience about Helen and Hugo, discovering this and wondering why Helen has his Hugo after being on her Needless to say, Merlin is pretty spooked out. Meanwhile, Arthur and Merlin swivel to
Wait. Let him go. He may be an idiot, but he's a brave one.
There's something about you, Merlin. I can't quite put my finger on.
Merlin continues to get strange calls from an unknown source in the nighttime. He wakes up, and he distracts the guards with the dice before heading into the grounds of the dungeons to hear his calling. The dragon arrives from the deep. This dragon says it's Merlin's job to help Arthur defeat, to become his friend and defeat friend and foe, to become future king and unite all of Albion under the kingdoms. As him, as Arthur, as the main king. Now, Merlin's views to help Morgana with nightmares. Now Merlin has to protect Morgana with some potions. Wow, they believed in anything back then, didn't they? I mean, probably the same as today. And antidepressants that we use today. Here's some potion, give it to Morgana. He arrives awkwardly and hands the potions over before quickly getting out of there after Morgana thinks that she is Gwen.
In a scene following, we see the old hag, now turned into Helen 2, as I like to call her, kill another person, another unlucky victim. After, you know, she notices who she really is in the reflection in the mirror, which reveals that she is the old hag that threatened the king. In our next scene, the big banquet party for the arrival of Helen begins, and in the scene we see the arrival of Morgana, who, lo and behold, comes to the party. Even though she was kind of refusing it, she was kind of forced into it. Then we, you know, see her arrival, and basically heads turn and people stare. She's pretty beautiful, I gotta say. In our next kind of awkward scene, we're back to Merlin and Gwen talking at the banquet. And, you know, Merlin's staring, but to make, you know, Merlin feel a little more adequate, she says, I'm more into normal guys to, you know, make her seem approachable. I mean, she's kind of putting a few steps forward here for a relationship to begin. She says, I like normal people just like you, Merlin. You can tell, you know, Merlin might be a bit about this relationship, but she's kind of going for it, and yeah. So next up, we kind of get to the main event of the evening, where Lady Helen begins to sing, and she sings very nicely, operatically. But suddenly, people start to fall asleep, people start to come into a slumber, except for clever Merlin, who kind of was suspecting something from Helen, so, you know, he blocked his ears, you know, to stop himself from being put down to this. And cobwebs start to appear, and yeah, things about it get pretty creepy.
In her last words, or in her last moments of strength, she throws a knife at the awakened Arthur before Merlin dodges, pulling Arthur down as the knife goes into the back of the chair, saving his life. Uther thanks him and says that he owes him a great debt, saying he will become Prince Arthur's manservant, to a sort of kind of disappointed Merlin, but kind of shocked, and to an annoyed and pissed off looking Arthur. Gaius says that he has found a new use for magic after all for Merlin, and tells him that this is probably his purpose, to serve Arthur in the future. Merlin still looks a bit, you know, lost at the moment, and soon after, Gaius gives Merlin a book wrapped in tarp, a book of magic. Credits roll, and that is the end of our first episode. So, that was The Dragon's Call, the first episode of Merlin. I think this was a really good introductory episode, with great, unique introductions. The unique and brave Merlin, of course, you know, him being a bit mischievous, but doing it for good. The wise and grateful Gaius, and the brash and arrogant Arthur, who in fairness is quite a nuisance in the episode, but I can see some charm forming for him. Of course, we were presented with the beautiful and medieval town of Camelot, which is presented in many stories, which is incredibly real and it really brings the world to life. The fantasy magic element is clear and reinventing it in this episode. What we see is really quite cool and it doesn't feel dated and actually is quite believable, but it makes it feel quite close to today's standards. And for me personally, I think it's modern, but it doesn't stray away from the source material, and is quite it looks at the source material, but manages to stay relevant today. At the end of this episode, Merlin does defeat the evil magical creature thing with magic, which I love, and it is officially when he becomes important and starts to make a mark on the world. Merlin now learns that he can use magic for good, and for use he can feel that a curse is a blessing for once. This is overall an excellent pilot episode, and as pilots go, it's simple enough for any non-people familiar with the Arthur lore to follow, but also great for, you know, fans of that Arthur legends that came in the past, that we kind of know of. A lot of people know of, at least. Next, I review the second episode of Series 1, Valiant, which is a great, fun episode. See you all then, and hopefully you stick back for the next episode. See you all next time, bye. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed that video. I put that together very nicely for you guys, just because I wanted you. And this is a TV show review, and remember, Merlin is a show that I really enjoy, and I'm going to be doing 2 reviews a week of this show. Now, the whole new schedule for me, if you haven't heard already, it's going to be one of these reviews on Monday, again on Thursday, and then the Friday show on Friday. So hopefully that schedule will work and won't fall through. But we'll see, because school is coming up again next week, very close. So we'll see, you know, what happens in the time being. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. Make sure you like, subscribe, comment below, share, and do all you can to support me. See you all next time. Bye, guys.